Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It is Ken and BC here, and in this video I'm going to be going over some hidden features that are inside the Facebook Ad Manager. I'm sure not a lot of people know about all these features, and honestly some of them I just discovered them recently. Some you may have known about, some you don't know about at all, but by the end of this video you're going to learn a few of them. And I'm sure that they're going to really help you, you know, improve your ad results if you take them seriously. So right here on the screen, you can see we just have the normal Facebook ad dashboard. If you've been running ads or if you've run ads before, you'll be familiar with this dashboard. And with this dashboard, you basically get access to a very number of analytics, right? Just a few analytics based on the type of campaign that you're running. So if it's a conversion campaign, you'll be able to see like your purchases. If you're running a leads campaign, you'll be able to see the number of leads, you'll be able to see the number of reach, impressions, the cost per result, that's whatever you are trying to run an ad for. And then you'll be able to see the amount spent, you know, the link clicks and other basic stuff. But what if you wanted to see more details about the advert? What if, for example, you wanted to know, like, let's say, how many likes or how many reactions came in through your advert? Or if you want to know, okay, what platform actually is bringing the likes and, you know, the followers or the reaction? No, not followers, but like the reactions on your content. How would you be able to find it out? So most people don't know about it, but I'm going to show you how to find that now. It's simply this menu over here. So you can see these two columns here. This first one that says columns performance, right? And then this second one that says breakdown. These two are the places that you go to when you need to see those kind of details. So if I click on this columns here, the first one, you can see a bunch of details that I have access to. There's setup, there's delivery, engagement, video engagement, app engagement, carousel engagement, performance and clicks, cross device, offline conversions, targeting and creative, bidding and optimization, messaging engagement. Alright, so you can see them. And another interesting thing that you can do here is that you can also customize the columns. So you can see these ones that have an X at the end here simply means that I've customized them. These ones were not inside this column originally, right? They are not there originally. I customized them, I created them by myself and gave them their individual names. That's why you can see them here. So if you want to use them, or if you want to create something like this, all you have to do is click on customize columns. And when you click on customize columns, you're going to see a whole dialog box is going to open that contains all the different type of results and, you know, analytics that you can see for your adverts. So you can see there's performance, under engagement, you know, there's conversions, there's settings, A/B tests, and optimization. So there's a lot of things that you can actually check if you are very, very concerned about the kind of results that you're getting. I want to check everything, right? There's a lot of things that you can go through. I might not be able to go through every single one after the other, but in case you need any particular analytics, maybe someone asked you or you just want to show someone something about your adverts, feel free to come in here and you're going to get a lot of analytics data. You can see for page posts, for example, if you are running an engagement ad and want to see, you know, number of reactions, save, shares, that kind of thing, all those kind of things are coming through your post. You can see all of them here. So the page engagement, you can see page likes, post comments, engagement, reactions, saves, shares, photo views, event responses, check-ins. You can see, so there's a lot of details here, and that's just under engagement. You move over to page and post, you can see the cost. You move over to messaging, you can see the new messaging that you got, the ones that were blocked. You can see, so there's a lot of details in here that normally people who just run ads on a daily basis, they don't have an idea that this exists. They just run their adverts and then they don't check all these data. This data is very, very important, because if you are running a campaign that is running into millions of cash, you really want to know exactly what your campaign is doing. So to use any of this or to see any of this on your dashboard, all you have to do is simply click on this tick box by the side. Once you click on it, it will be added over to the menu over here, right? So if I can see, if I click on this one that says cost per unique click, and I scroll down, you can see it has been added here, cost per unique click all. And you can always adjust it. You can just hold this. So if you hold it down, you can adjust it. You can drag it up, or you can drag it down and you can leave it down there. All right, so you can see there's a lot of things here, a lot of options. When it comes to the conversions, there are a lot of things as well, you know, add to cart, add to wish list, app activations, app installs, different metrics that you can all include. And this is also great for when you're doing reporting. You know, some clients might want to just see all these numbers for themselves to know what they can do with it. This really helps you to do that effectively. And then coming down to this section, you can see we still have other details on the account, like the account ID, the account name, the campaign ID, asset ID, you know, stuff like that, the date when the campaign was created, date when it was last edited, all that kind of stuff. Everything is inside here, the bid strategy, the audiences that you excluded, the ad creative, you know, the page name, the headline, the body, the destination, the preview link. So it's very, very detailed, right? I told you guys recently, I just took time to explore this place and I was like, wow, there are so many events here that people don't normally even check on a normal day, and which will really help them with their ads so that they know what they are doing. So you can see a bunch of them. You can feel free to go through them. But once you're done selecting the ones that you want, all you have to do is come over here and click on Save as Preset. So when you click on Save as Preset, you can simply give it a name. So I will just say maybe test. Test. Sorry, let me type in test. So if I say test, and then I can choose the attribution window I want. Normally, by default, it's 28-day click and 1-day view. You can also choose a window comparison, but I don't like to use that. I'll just leave it as this, you know, set the preset as test, and then I'll click on apply. And then you're going to see right now, you can see here, I have a new preset for my columns, which is test. So if I click on it, any changes that I made to that test column would automatically show in my dashboard. If I deleted all the analytics and left only one, it will still show on my dashboard. So that's why this column is very important. The next one is this other breakdown here. And breakdown is also like the first one, but it also gives you more data. So you can see by time, that's your advert. You can see by time, by delivery, and by action. By time simply refers to, you know, so let me, for example, if I click on day, you'll be able to see your data by each day, right? All the days that the ads were active, you'll be able to see what was happening on each day, the amount of results that came in. Same thing you can do for a week, same thing you can do for 2 weeks, same thing you can do for a month. When it comes to delivery, you can see other details here. You can see the age, so it will break down the ad, all the advert campaigns by age. For gender, it will break it down by gender. For age and gender, it will break it down by age and gender as well. For business locations, country, region, all this, they all have their place. And for things like business location or country, it would not really matter, except you are running a campaign that involves multiple countries. So if you are running a campaign that has to do with other countries outside Nigeria, then that would really work for you. So there are a lot of other options. Another one that I really like to check out once in a while is the time of day, because some people always want to know, you know, the best time of the day when their adverts were performing. So if they use this option here that says time of day, you can actually check what time of the day the users or the audience was engaging with your ad the most. And then if you choose to do a scheduled campaign, you can just choose what time of the day that you want your adverts to show, and then that's the only time that your adverts to show. So very interesting stuff here. There's also device, so you can see which devices are bringing the most impressions or which devices people are using to view your adverts the most. This can help you if you're running an awareness campaign or a reach campaign on something like Instagram. It can be really, really helpful. And then the third one is by action. So conversion device, that's where the conversion took place, what device they were using, when they either made a purchase, you know, that sort of thing. There's post reaction type, There is destination, video view type, video sound, and carousel card, right? So these are just a bunch of very detailed analytics. And this is why people say that Facebook is very powerful. Most people don't understand when I say Facebook is very powerful. It's because all this data, you are getting it by simply running your adverts on Facebook or either on Instagram. You're simply getting access to all this data. And then imagine what you can do with all this data. You can, you know, you can share it to people. You can help other business owners. You can help your own business. You can optimize your adverts. You can really do a lot of things with it. That's why it's very, very important. And then we have the reports tab as well, although there's another tab for reports. But here you can access your reports right now. You can create a custom report for your adverts and you know, be able to analyze it. Maybe if you have a team or you have someone who analyzes your ad for you, you can share it with them and they will look over it and tell you, okay, this is what you did wrong. This is how to correct it and this is how to go from here. So those are just a few of the things when it comes to the normal ad manager. The next thing we're going to look at is if we come to this menu, the business tools option over here, and then you look at this menu over here. There's a lot of tools here that most people have never even ventured to click on. All they know is they come inside here, they just put money in their account and they go ahead to run their adverts. No, you want to explore more things inside the account because there are a lot of things here that can really help you. And one of those kind of things is called the Creative Hub. So with the Creative Hub, you can basically create your adverts as a mock-up, and then you can see how the thing looks on either on your phone or your laptop before you go ahead to either run the advert or to spend money on the advert. You simply create a mock-up on your system using just an image and a text, and you can see how the advert will look like on people's phones before you go ahead to run it as an actual ad. Another thing is automated rules. Automated rules is very, very powerful and very important, especially if you are spending money on adverts. And let's say, for example, you don't want to exceed your particular budget. You set a particular budget for your adverts and you don't want your budget to exceed that amount. You can use automated rules. You can set automated rules in your on your campaign. So if you want to say, okay, if this campaign spends up to 10,000, I want it to automatically stop. Or if I get a particular number of impressions or, you know, results, I just want it to stop. I want it to change the budget. You know, I want it to reduce it, that kind of thing. So that's what automated rules does for you. So those two are very, very powerful. There's a bunch of other analytics here, which I would not go into because this video is getting too long already. But if there's anything that you've noticed in your Facebook ad manager that you find interesting and you've not been able to explore, simply let me know in the comment section and I will try as much as possible to answer it and give you solutions to it. Also, if you are having issues running Facebook and Instagram ads, you want it resolved and you also want to learn how to get the best results with your Facebook and Instagram ads, do not forget to click the link in the description. Check out the Facebook ads training bundle. It's really going to help you, especially this time of the year, to get more sales, more customers, and more results using your adverts. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really appreciate you. If you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, and turn on the notification bell so you get notified once I make a new video on the channel. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next one.